to know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
It wasn't the first British Darbar in Delhi, but it was certainly the biggest and perhaps the most significant. On 7th of December 1911, King George V and Queen Mary of Great Britain led a huge procession from Salimgarh near the Red Fort to the Coronation Park, a large dusty plain to the north of the city. After a journey to India by sea, they had arrived by train from Bombay to be formally acknowledged as Emperor and Empress of India. It was the first visit of a British monarch to India, literally the jewel in his crown. After receiving a 101-gun salute, the royals led the way, followed by the Viceroy, Lord Hardinge, and other officials. Then followed several hundred of the subcontinent's Maharajas, Rajas, and Nawabs, whom the British referred to as chiefs, led by the Nizam of Hyderabad, Usman Ali Khan. The 1911 Darbar was held in this city of about 4,000 tents spread across 25 square miles, and on which nearly £1 million were spent and paid for by the colonial government and the people of India, besides, of course, the personal expense of India's royals. But the Darbar was also remarkable for two other reasons. During the course of official celebrations that lasted until 16th December, the annulment of the first partition of Bengal was announced by George V. He also declared, "We have decided upon the transfer of the seat of the government of India from Calcutta to the ancient capital of Delhi." George V laid the foundation stone for New Delhi, a modern imperial city to eclipse even that of the Mughals. But George V certainly behaved like a Mughal. He presided over a parade of 50,000 troops. He doled out numerous honors. The highest, Knight Grand Commander of the most exalted star of India, was awarded to Ganga Singh of Bikaner, Umed Singh of Kota, Jagajit Singh of Kapurthala, the Nizam of Hyderabad, and Muhammad Shah, the third Aga Khan. India's royals, among them the Begum of Bhopal, Kai Khusra of Jahan, were treated and seated according to the gun salute hierarchy. The Nizam and the rulers of Mysore and Baroda had pride of place on account of their 21 gun salutes accorded by Britain. Others followed in the order of 19, 17, 15, 13, 11, and 9 gun salutes. King George and Queen Mary visited the Red Fort and even held Jharoka Darshan, a public viewing from a balcony of the fort in the style of the Mughals. They were eager to depart on a journey across India and a hunting trip to Nepal. International media and nascent film companies vied with each other for access and coverage of the months-long visit. But underneath all this simmered a resentment. The scandal of the Darbar came when Sayaji Rao Gaikwad III of Baroda bowed once instead of the prescribed 3 times and turned to walk back to his place instead of walking backward. It was taken as a huge insult. The Gaikwad was later pressured to apologize, but this event signaled imminent change for such galas that had become the high point of the empire. When the administration of British India passed from the East India Company to the Crown after the revolt of 1857, which also marked the demise of the Mughal Empire, the imperious attitude transferred seamlessly. Queen Victoria was proclaimed Empress of India in 1876. In India, it was celebrated in 1877 at Coronation Park. The Viceroy, Lord Lytton, presided over the ceremony. Even though it took place in the wake of acute famine in central and northern India, over 100 Maharajas, Nawabs and Rajas, besides the Princess of Tanjore and the Begum of Bhopal, gathered to pay homage to Victoria. The display was grander at the Second Delhi Darbar in 1903. In the wake of a great famine that killed people and cattle in the millions, It was held to mark the reign of Edward VII. The Viceroy, Lord Curzon, supervised lavish and minute details alike. The royal camps were provided sanitation facilities and electricity. String bands played at night. Pavilions were set up near the present-day interstate bus terminal to exhibit art and jewellery of India's royals. A ball was held at the Red Fort, for which Curzon ordered alterations to the Diwani Aam and the Diwani Khas. A special telegraph office at the site transmitted Curzon's speech on 1st January to the media in London. Curzon even found time to replace the lost Darbar medal of the Nizam of Hyderabad, Mehboob Ali Khan. Talk of a fourth Darbar in the 1930s came to nothing. Besides criticism in both Britain and India of the massive expenses, rising Indian nationalism would have made another Darbar hugely unpopular. That sentiment endures. Coronation Park is today a refuge of colonial relics, among them a defaced marble statue of George V.